Hi, I'm John. We're continuing our series taking a look at Visual Studio for Mac, building awesome .NET applications. In our previous video, we just looked at building a simple console application. And I mentioned that as you build more complex applications, you're going to want to take advantage of the more advanced features in Visual Studio for Mac. So in this video, we're just going to do a whirlwind tour of tons of cool features, just little tips and tricks to help you be more productive. Just getting started here, taking a look at the preferences. Now, I know it's maybe not that productive to play with your color themes, but it is neat to know that I can. So I can go through here, I can download color themes off the internet. We support VS Settings, but also Xamarin Studio Text and TextMate as well. So those are really cool. I am partial to the Dracula theme, but you do you. Another cool thing as you're going through this is we have support for code snippets. So there's some built-in ones, which are nice. So you can type instead of typing constructor syntax over and over, you type CTOR, hit tab, and there you go. But you can add your own in. So this is handy if there's things that you're typing over and over regularly, or even if you're doing a little code demonstration and showing off something to someone else, it's nice to have those snippets available. So another thing as you're going through and building your applications, you're going to find that you have your own coding conventions that you and maybe your team use. So we have support for editor config. Editor config is a really cool, it's a format, it's actually a standard that's supported by a lot of different editors. So Visual Studio for Mac is one of them. You can grab this and you can go through and you can set, you know, what is your tab size and what are all your policies. And what's neat is you can actually check this in with your source code. And so someone that clones your repository is actually getting your set of coding standards along with that. So as you're building your applications, you're going to be making changes. And we've got great support in here for Git as well. So I can go in here and look at this. And I can click on my log. And I can see what are the changes and who made them. And I can go through and compare and diff those changes over time. So there's, of course, support for committing and setting my commit messages and pushing everything. But it's also nice to be able to, in the browser, see my code changes as I go. So as I'm building my applications, here I'm looking at a unit test. And I actually want to be able to run those unit tests. So I could go over to a console and do that. But we've actually got support. If I go View, Pads, there is a unit test pad. And so now I can visualize my unit tests and I can run them directly in the editor. So here I can go through and I can say run all my unit tests and it's actually going to build and run those in the editor. I can see them as they're running and see the results. And then I can actually just rerun specific unit tests if a certain one fails. So I can use this also to navigate through and I can say, oh, here's my failing unit test and navigate directly to it. So that's really handy and encourages good coding behavior to just be, you know, building and using my unit tests as I'm developing. So also, you'll see that this is a relatively large application. I've got lots of different projects in here, and I'm going to want to be able to navigate around through this. Okay, so this is an application with a lot of different projects, and some of these I want to have start up when my application runs to run them as a group. For instance, I've got backend services that my web application is going to talk to. And in order to make that easier, I can go in and I can configure multiple startups. So I can go in here and I can say I can configure multiple web app or multiple startup projects, and I could say I would like to start together my functions and my web application, but I don't need my health checks or tests to run every time I'm running. So that's a great example of a custom start configuration, and I can create multiple different ones of those. So also, as I'm building my web app, it's nice to be able to deploy directly from here. So I may be wanting to push this, you know, to a test endpoint running on Azure, for instance. So I can write in here, I can go and I can publish to a folder, or I can go through and publish to Azure, and it'll go through and find all my subscriptions, and I can publish directly from there. So now, as I'm building my application, I'm going to want to be able to refactor and test out my code quality. So there's tons of refactorings that are just built directly in. And I like to just kind of move my mouse around and look for the little icons and light bulbs, you know, and see, do I like this, this style better? Is this going to be a better way of doing this check or whatever, right? So here it's giving me an example that I could use a discard here for instance, or I could use a local variable. So this also helps me with a lot of like code cleanup tasks. Here I've got some usings that I don't need, and I can go through and remove those unnecessary usings. So that's pretty handy as well. As I'm going through, one nice feature that we've been working hard on lately is we're actually sharing source code between Visual Studio for Windows and Visual Studio for Mac. And so there's a lot of really cool editor features that we've been adding here. There's been some really good updates for accessibility, and that integrates directly with Visual Studio for Mac features like VoiceOver. But there's also just some neat things where I can go through and I can create multiple cursors. So here I'm holding down Control Option and clicking, and I can go through and in multiple places, I can set a cursor, and then I can say, right, and I can go through and make multiple edits. I can also do a block select by holding down Option while I select a group of text. And then there's just some neat little things I can do, like I can move things up and down. I can swap lines by holding down Option and up arrow. So up and down arrow, and I'm toggling those two lines. So tons of great little things in here. I encourage you to take some time and look at the docs, and you'll see they're spelled out in there. So as I'm navigating through large code bases, I'm going to be searching through my code, and there's really great search support built into Visual Studio for Mac. So I can click directly in the search box, or I can hit Command dot to pop up there, and then I can search all over. So if I know I'm looking for a YouTube service, right, I can go directly to that, and it's got them broken out by, you know, solutions, files, etc. I can also filter this down here, so I can say, I know I'm looking for a type, and my type is startup, and it'll take me directly to that. So that's a really handy way to navigate through a large code base. And there's even support in here for commands. So I can search directly for commands. So I could say command, and then I can do things like run or activate or stop debugging. So there's tons of commands that are built directly in here. So I can actually very quickly hit command dot and navigate through, even if I don't know the hotkey, I can navigate very quickly through this as well. So that wraps up our whirlwind look at some Visual Studio for Mac features. Be sure and check out the docs to see there's quite a bit more we have for you. And come back for our next video when we'll be looking at how you can get more involved with the .NET ecosystem.